This is lecture for BSc first year student and paper is geometry fourth paper semester second. So dear student, in the last lecture we were studied relationship between the direction cosine of line, suppose L, M and N are three direction cosine of any line L which is in the space, that means in three dimensional geometry. Then the relation between them is L square plus M square plus N square is equal to 1. That means sum of square of direction cosine of line is equal to 1. Okay, so student, one corollary is there. What is that? One corollary is there, and that is if A, B and C be three numbers, A, B, C be three numbers. Okay, these are any three numbers, but these numbers are proportional to direction cosine, are proportional to L, M and N respectively. So ABC are the three numbers which are directly proportional to direction cosine LMM, then what will happen? So we can write this L divided by A is equal to M divided by B is equal to N divided by C, and this can be written as plus minus square root of L square plus M square plus N square divided by square root of A square plus B square plus C square. So here we used theorem on equal ratio. So dear student, you have already studied what it means by theorem on equal ratio. I think it was in 10th standard, and application of the theorem on equal ratio start from 10th standard to till date. So this is the application of theorem on equal ratio. So L and A are in proportion, M and B are in proportion, N and C are in proportion. So we can write like this, plus minus root L square plus M square plus N square divided by A square plus B square. You can check it for any three any numbers. Suppose you assign the value, any value for L, M, N and A, B, C. But it must be necessary, they should be in proportion. Then we can verify this term. So no objection, it is the trivial. So here now we know that L square plus M square plus N square is 1. This is our theorem. What is that? L square plus M square plus N square is 1. This L square plus M square plus N square is 1. So here plus minus root L square plus M square plus N square divided by root of A square plus B square plus C square. So I can write this L by A is equal to M by B is equal to N by C is equal to plus minus 1 divided by square root of A square plus B square plus C square. Now there is a one question, that is whether we have to take plus or minus. So where the same sign, positive or negative, it is to be chosen throughout the theory. So it is depend upon, actually this is nothing but the value of LMN. That means we can find this direction ratio L as plus minus 1 upon square root of A square plus B square plus C square. Then M can be written as plus minus B upon root of A square plus B square plus C square. Similarly, L, M, N can be written as plus minus 1 upon square root of A square plus B square plus C square. That means this L, M, N we have written in the form of direction ratios. And what are the direction ratios? A, B, C are any three numbers are the direction ratios. Now again we can write this LMN in other form like this. L can be written as, see here, this is a L. And I can write it is in another different form, that is 1 upon square root of summation A square. So I write here only A square. I written here only A square. So what's about the B square and C square? So meaning of this term summation A square means, see here, summation A square means A square plus B square plus C square. So considering this term, summation A square is equal to A square plus B square plus C square, we write here L is equal to in this way. And one second. This L can be written as A into 1. This A into 1. So there is a A, this is very most important, there B and this is a C, there is C. So here we get A, here we get A. So this is a L. So similarly, we can find M is equal to plus minus B upon square root of summation A square. And similarly, N can be written as plus minus C upon square root of summation A square. So in this way we get LMN, that means the direction ratio in terms of direction cosine. So student, one thing is that we have already discussed the line make angle. This is a three-dimensional geometry, okay, and suppose this is a line, this is a line L, makes an angle alpha with a positive direction of x-axis, then simultaneously this line makes an angle pi minus alpha. That means if I extend this line like this, this is a z-axis, okay, not this. This is the angle. So this angle is pi minus alpha. That means this line L make alpha, beta, gamma in positive direction of x-axis. So similar angle pi minus alpha, pi minus beta, and pi minus gamma make with negative direction of x-axis. So if the line make positive direction of x axis alpha beta gamma are direction cosines of that line. Similarly, when the line make angle pi minus alpha pi minus beta pi minus gamma, so that times also we can find out the direction cosine of that line. So what's about the direction cosine of line? So here we was already discussed cos alpha is equal to L, cos beta is equal to M, and cos gamma is equal to N. So similarly for this angle alpha, we replace this by pi minus alpha. So we get cos of pi minus alpha, but cos of pi minus alpha is nothing but minus cos theta. There is a cos of pi minus theta is minus cos theta. So this is formula. This is formula. So here cos of pi minus alpha is minus L. Similarly, cos of pi minus beta is minus M, and cos of pi minus gamma is minus N. That means this is a line OP and this is a line OP dash. OP dash. Suppose this is point P. See here. This is a point P of XYZ. And there is a point P dash of XYZ. So this is the OP dash and this is the OP and this is the OP dash distance. So in this way, so this OP dash line, this OP dash line is nothing but that is of the line OP, of the line OP produces back one. Produce backwards. So student, today we stop here. And whether the line makes angle positive or negative, if we take this direction cosine or this direction cosine, it is depend upon at that time by in which direction we are going to calculate the direction cosine. But remember that this relation, see here, this relation f square plus m square plus n square is equal to 1 stay as it is. It is retained constant whether the LMN are positive or LMN are negative. So dear student, here we have discussed about the direction cosine and direction ratio. So in next lecture we will try to solve some problem. Thank you.